What's up guys, Sal here. So Samsung releases two flagship phones a year, the Galaxy S phones that they launch at the beginning of the year and the Galaxy Note phones that they launch in the second half of the year. The Galaxy Note 10 is Samsung's next flagship phone, which is about to launch in August. But in a very surprising move, the Galaxy Note 10 isn't the only flagship scheduled for the latter half of the year. Samsung will launch another device in the A series, which is also worthy of being called a flagship phone, and it's called the Galaxy A90. Today we got some specifications of the handset, courtesy of OnLeaks, which reveals that the Galaxy A90 will have a flagship processor. Yes, it will have the Snapdragon 855 SoC that we find on devices like the Galaxy S10 and the upcoming Galaxy Note 10. This is a very surprising move because the Galaxy A90 will still land on Samsung's mid-range Galaxy A series of devices. Traditionally, we see the A series getting a mid-range or upper mid-range processors, but it looks like it's changing with the Galaxy A90, and I'm really happy about that. We also have other information. There will be two versions of this device, a regular LTE and a 5G version. Both will have a massive 6.7 inches of display, similar to the Galaxy Note 10. The Note 10, by the way, has a 6.75 inches of display. There will be an in-display fingerprint scanner. No information about whether it's going to be ultrasonic scanner like on the S10 or a normal optical scanner like you find on literally every other device. My guess would be optical. Samsung still has to cut corners on this device, and they have to make sure the A90 won't overshadow their main Galaxy S and Note flagship phones. So it would be optical, I guess. Anyway, there will be a triple camera setup at the back, and these are the camera configuration of the handset. As you can see, he hasn't mentioned anything about the front camera. I guess that's because the Galaxy A90 will also have a rotating camera, just like the Galaxy A80 that Samsung released a few months ago. Steve has mentioned the LTE version will have an exclusive tilt OIS tech. Not really sure what this exactly means, but you can guess that it is related to the rotating camera and has to do with the optical image stabilization. It's good to see that optical image stabilization will finally be making a comeback to Samsung's mid-range phones, or I might say the Galaxy A series of devices, because clearly the Galaxy A90 is no longer a mid-range device. Of course, that being said, pretty exciting build so far. With the information we have right now, it's clear that the A90 will also have a full screen edge-to-edge display with a sliding and rotating camera mechanism, just like the Galaxy A80. But the difference is that the A90 will have a flagship processor and some more additional features. Companies like OnePlus should be worried about this device. It looks like Samsung will price this around $700, which is how much the OnePlus 7 Pro costs. So definitely Samsung is targeting this segment, and indeed OnePlus has something to worry about here. That said, Samsung also shouldn't repeat the same mistakes they did with the Galaxy A80. Once they launched the A90, Samsung has to make sure that they release it in less than a month. You see, the A80 was released in March, but the phone doesn't seem to be actually available for purchase anywhere. And now Samsung has confirmed that they will release it in early July, which is almost 4 months since the launch, which is way too late. I hope that doesn't happen with the A90, because other companies aren't waiting, except for Sony. Let me know your thoughts on this handset. Would you get this over a device like the Galaxy Note 10 if they price it between $700 to $800? Let me know.